Hello students, today we will do Social Science History Chapter 4, The Mughal Empire. In this chapter, we will read about all the rulers ruling during Mughal Empire, that is Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir and Shah Jahan, and Aurangzeb. We will read one by one about them, the battles they fought, the military reforms they performed, the sources of the knowledge, the policies which they made, and many more. This chapter will be in modules. This is the first module of this chapter. Let's begin the topic. Introduction to the Mughal Empire. Mughals created an empire and accomplished what had up till now seemed possible for only short periods. They expanded their kingdom from Agra to Delhi. Who are Mughals? The Mughals were descendants of two great lineage of rulers. From their mother's side, they were descendants of Genghis Khan, the ruler of Mongol tribe China and Central Asia. And from their father's side, they were successor of Timur, the ruler of Iran, Iraq and modern-day Turkey. The first six Mughal rulers were the most popular and powerful ones are Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan and the last is Aurangzeb. Let's read about their time of rule. Babur from 30 April 1526 to 26 December 1930. Humayun from 26 December 1530 to 17th May 1540, and he covered his time period from 22 February 1555 from 27 January 1556. Akbar time period was 27 January 1556 from 27 October 1606. Jahangir's was 15 October 1605 to 18 November 1627. Shah Jahan was 8 November 1627 to 2 August 1658. And Aurangzeb was 31 July 1658 to 3 March 1707. We will read first about the first emperor of Mughal, that is Babur. Students, Mughal Empire was founded by Babur. Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur was born on 14 February 1489, sometime also spelt Babur or Babur. He founded the Mughal Empire after his victories at the Battle of Panipat in 1526 and the Battle of Khanwa. He was the direct descendant of Timur from the Barlas clan through his father and also a descendant of Genghis Khan through his mother. Ousted from the ancestral domains in Central Asia, Babur turned to India to satisfy his ambition. After Babur fell seriously ill, Humayun, his eldest son, was summoned from his Jahangir. He died at the age of 47 on 26 December 1533 and was succeeded by Humayun. A portrait of Babur from early illustrated manuscript of Baburnama from 1589 and 90, you can see him. The first battle of Panipat was on 21 April 1526, which was fought between the invading forces of Babur and the Lodi Empire. The Battle of Khanwa was fought near the village of Khanwa, about 60 km west of Agra, on March 17, 1527. It was the second battle fought in modern day of India by first Mughal Emperor Babur after the Battle of Panipat. Now we will read about the next ruler of Mughal Empire, that is Humayun. Nasiruddin Muhammad Humayun was born on 17 March 1508 in Kabul, Afghanistan. Babur celebrated the birth of Humayun in the Chaharbagh of Kabul. Humayun with his father Babur. Humayun succeeded his father in 1531 as the ruler of Mughal territory in India. At the age of 23, Humayun was an inexperienced ruler when he came to the power. Sher Shah Suri defeated Humayun at Chausa in 1539 and at Kannauj at 1540, expelling him from India while wandering from one place to another. His son Akbar was born at Umrao on October 14, 1542. Humayun's tomb in Delhi, India. Humayun conquered the Punjab, Delhi and Agra and reoccupied the throne of Delhi after an interval of 15 years. Humayun slipped and fell down the stair and fractured his skull. He was then carried to the palace and died on 26 January 1556. Humayun and Sher Shah. The first battle between them was in 1532, in which Humayun won and Sher Shah lost. Second battle was in Chausa and Kannauj in 1539, in which Sher Shah won and exiled to Persia. Moving ahead to the Sur dynasty. This was dynasty of Sher Shah. His real name was Farid Khan. He was called as Sher, that is Tiger. Administration he followed was reformed land revenue, introduction of rupiah, that is silver coin, reduced custom duties on road, that is Grand Trunk Road. Now Sher Shah Suri, he ascended the throne in 1540 CE. And ruled for a brief but glorious 5 years. In his short span, he built a vast empire that stretched from River Jhelum in the west to the River Brahmaputra in the east, and from Himalayas in the north to the River Narmada in the south. Sher Shah was the son of Jahangirdar from Sasaram in Bihar. His actual name was Farid. He was given the name Sher after he killed a lion with his bare hand. Moving ahead to reforms of Sher Shah. He improved the weak administration and maintained a powerful army. He also introduced several reforms in the land for the welfare of the people and their society. He constructed an excellent network of road called Sadak-e-Azam, known as the Grand Trunk Road. He also established several inns on roadsides and improved the communication system as well as apsonage, all for the safety of the travelers, especially women and children, on the highways. He introduced new reform currency, a silver coin called rupiah. He encouraged trade and commerce and treated all merchants with respect and reduced custom duties. He was a secular ruler and followed a policy of religious tolerance. Many of Sher Shah's reforms were followed by Akbar, and he is often regarded as Akbar's predecessor with regard to being a secular and benevolent ruler. Moving ahead to post Sher Shah Suri. After Sher Shah death in 1545 CE, he was succeeded by Islam Shah. Islam Shah was not a very capable ruler but could not match up to Sher Shah brilliance. As a result, Humayun, with the help of Sher Shah of Persia, reclaimed the Mughal throne in 1555 CE. After defeating him, Humayun's victory was again short-lived as he died a year later. After falling down the stair from his library in Purana Kila in Delhi, he succeeded by his son Akbar, who was only 13 years old at that time. This is it for the module 1. The rest chapter we will continue in module 2. Thank you.